Good morning from Nakpan Beach here in the Philippines. Guys, this is just absolute paradise. Look how long this beach is. We got beautiful sand and we got a beautiful day with some blue and turquoise water. It is just absolutely paradise up here. We've got the coconut trees, all the little boats and stuff. But it is a beautiful day here in Nakpan Beach. We're about 20 kilometers away from El Nido town. And as a kid, I used to do a lot of camping. Used to go out with my dad, with my mum, with my siblings, and we used to kind of rough it up in a little tent out by the lakes in Australia. But today, we're not roughing it up anymore because we're doing glamping. We don't have to sleep on any air mattresses. We have really good showers and toilets that we can use. So I'm gonna be bringing you along for the day as I show you the tent that we're staying in, all the things to do here in Nakpan Beach. There's some really cool cocktail bars down that way. And of course, a beautiful ocean and a beautiful scenery that you can dip off in and cool off because it is super hot. But Tara and I will bring you along for the day, everybody. It's a pretty nice place and I'm excited to show you all. Tara and I. So as I was saying, Nakpan Beach is about 20 kilometers away from El Nido. So it's very remote. It was actually very difficult to get here. The roads are super muddy and you actually need like a van or a big car to get through to this area of the beach. You can't get tricycles because they'll get stuck. But it's a super cool area. I don't know what this is, but these are some like really cool colored cottages that I think you can stay at. But it's just absolute paradise, guys. Anywhere with like a coastline full of coconut trees, get me there because I know it's gonna be an awesome time. And I've been having a lot of coconuts here. I got here yesterday afternoon and it was absolutely gorgeous. But now, since we have the full day here today, I'm gonna be bringing you all along for the journey. And we'll show you what we get up to. This will probably be a very long vlog because there's a lot of things to do here. There's so many restaurants to eat at, so many beautiful cocktails, so many activities that you can do. These little beach shots here are specifically for the glamping. And then there's a sister hotel where they have like a restaurant and stuff. But this is the area. Like, it's just an oasis. Hello, brother. Kamusta ka? You're good? But yeah, this is kind of the entrance area. They must have a lot of turtles here because I've been seeing like all these turtle signs. There's some more over there. It is turtle season. What month is turtle season?
November, sir.
So that is where they come up and they lay the eggs.
Yes, sir.
And do the eggs stay here or are they on?
Here, stay.
Really? Wow.
And if the eggs is dropped, the turtles go to the sea.
Oh, and then you release into the ocean. Oh, very good. But this glamping place here, they have tons of kind of free activities that you can do. Every night upon request, you can have a bonfire that they'll fix up for you and always add all the wood so you can sit by here, enjoy the bonfire. These are all like the glamping things. I think I'm at the one just behind it. So yeah, it's really cool. There's also a swimming pool that I'll check out shortly. But yeah, it's just absolutely awesome. Being right by the beach, like literally right by the doorstep of your tent is a beautiful beach that you can spend the day at. So I'll show you around and I'll show you where I'm staying. So we've got to get across this little bridge here to get to my glamping tent. So my one's just there. But before I show you the insides, I'm going to show you the bathroom. So the bathroom is actually not attached to the glamping area. It's kind of kamusta ka. But yeah, this is the communal shower area. So I think, you know, maybe there's like 8 or 10 glamping areas. Just check that there's no one in there. But this is the shower area. Got all your soaps and stuff. And then this is where you can brush your teeth. And then, of course, you wanna know how much I love bum guns. We gotta test out the bum gun here, but you actually can't be flushing any tissues or anything like that down the toilet, just because I don't think the sewer system here is as, I guess, extensive because we're so remote. So, got to make use of the bum gun and let's see what it's like. Bum gun test. Oh, look at that. Very small radius, but very powerful. I think it gets the job done. But, it's around 10 a.m. at the moment. And it is super hot. I'm already sweating. So during the day, because these tents, you know, they're kind of like a furnace. The heat just kind of heats up in them because they're all in the sun. They actually have AC in them, but it doesn't really work during the day just because it's so hot. During the day, it just literally heats up. It's like an oven. Similar to like the yurts that I stayed in Kyrgyzstan. But I'll show you the pool area. Here we go. So we've got the shower area here to wash off before you hop in to the pool. And this is the pool area. So during the day when the AC doesn't really work that much. Kamus the car.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Riley's back. You're staying at the same place I'm staying at.
Yeah, glamping.
Yeah. Enjoying the time in the pool.
Yeah,
it is beautiful.
Cocktail. Do you want one?
Really?
Yeah.
What did you get?
A beachaholic.
I'll be back. I'm gonna show them the room quickly and then I'll come for a dip.
See you soon.
Alright, so here we go. We are staying at number 9 here at glamping. I've said it a lot for you guys. I got them to clean the room this morning so we get the best impression that you can have for it all. But you got a couple deck chairs over here. You can chill out. They're kind of shaded, which is good. An escape from the sun because a few days ago, when I did the boat tour, guys, I got so burnt. Like, that's why I'm wearing the long sleeve shirt today, because any more sun on my back, I think I will be turning into a tomato. Well, I already am a tomato by the look of it. I'll show you guys later on. Actually, I'll show you guys now. I don't know how well you can see, but it's so red and it hurts so badly. But this is the outside area. Here we are. Let's open this all the way up. This is what glamping is like here in the Philippines, everybody. Toss that over. Oh, look at this, everybody. The perfect place to stay here at Nakpan Beach. It is just so aesthetic. Literally the perfect design. We've got two massive beds there. It's just like such a good vibe, you know? All the furniture, all the seating, fridges and whatnot, and everything that you can need. But yeah, give a little pan of everything. It's actually very spacious. So like, I remember when I was staying in a yurt in Kyrgyzstan, they're a lot kind of like smaller, depending, I guess, on the size of them. You can get big ones as well, but you can literally like fully stand in here. But the one thing is with these yurts and with these tents is that the higher up you are, the more the heat affects you. I'm literally like sweating right now. It is like gotta be like 35, 40 degrees up here. All the heated air is going up to the top, but down the bottom, it's really nice. And we got a little AC unit here that cools us off. We'll close this off once we leave just so we can not use all the electricity and we'll get some fresh air throughout the day. But yeah, this is it, everybody. So here we have the fridge. Got a nice bottle of water that came complimentary, which is actually, oh my God. That just blew up in my face. Look, look how full it is. That actually scared me. My first thought when that happened was firework blowing up in my hand, but I'm super sweaty. I need a big swig of this. That is refreshing. So, got a fridge in there. Got your freezer and stuff, a couple ice cubes, but we're not using any of that. But yeah, in terms of like the practicality here, it's actually really comfortable beds. Like, these are really soft mattresses. I got sandy feet, so I probably shouldn't put my feet on there, but I will move the towels and we'll do a cheeky bed test. Even though my back is so sunburnt, this is gonna absolutely kill. Let me wipe off a little bit of the sweat first. Here we go. And clean ourselves off. Perfect, all right. Bed test here, everybody. At Nakpan Glamping here in El Nido. This is gonna be a big fall because usually they're right on the floor. So let's do it. 3, 2, 1. Oh, that is comfortable. I already slept here last night, guys, so I know it's super comfortable. And actually, literally in the middle of the night, there was the biggest thunderstorm I've ever experienced. It felt like the lightning was actually on us. You know how sometimes when you hear like you see the flash and maybe it's like a couple seconds away? It was literally like flash, bang. So I was a little bit scared of getting struck by lightning during the middle of the night. But here are the condiments that you get your toothbrush and stuff. This little seating area just to eat and do your workout. Big power fan here, which is actually broken. I turned it on during the night and then this just came flying off. So that is not in operation. But one thing I will comment about this is that I'm amazed that there's no electrical fires here, just because we have this fridge plugged into this one. That's plugged into like this. That's like double plugged into that. Everything's just plugged into something else. And then that runs around over here to these fans where I'm charging all my phones and stuff. So everything is just like plugged into the one socket using all the electricity. I don't know where the AC is plugged into, but that has like a big pipe going outside. So it's just like fresh air. And then in here, it's cooling it all off. But yeah, this is a vibe. When the sun goes down and it's at nighttime and you have like this light here, it is just like the most aesthetically pleasing place to ever stay at. So yeah, I think that's all I have to show you here really. I will say they clean the room, but this morning there were so many bugs and mosquitoes. There's a spider over here somewhere that's roaming around in our bags. I'm not sure if he's out anywhere at the moment. But I know, to be fair, I left this open, but a couple ants having the time of their life in here, roaming around. But as you'd expect, you know, it may be glamping, but one thing that glamping doesn't do is get rid of the insects that is part of camping. So, oh, look at these guys. They're doing triples back to their nest with maybe a little bit of a chip, a little bit of a biscuit. Anyway, guys, I need a freshen off, I'm sweating. Let's go for a swim and we'll bring you along for the day here at Nakhman Beach, Taranup. As I was saying before, they do like a bonfire through the night. So that was that one up the very front that I showed you. But here's the second one, which I don't think has been in use. They probably just use the number one mostly. But yeah, looks pretty overgrown here. But yeah, look, that one's number 16. There's a spot there for number 17, but doesn't seem to have a tent. So there is at least 17, possibly more. There's another one over there. So there's a ton of these big tents on this property. And once we go further down the beach, I'll show you awesome things to do down there. Plenty of things to eat and enjoy the day.
This is how penguins waddle. And then they just dive like this.
It's mango and rum.
Oh, that's nice.
It is really nice.
Mmm. I love the cup that it comes in.
Yeah.
Is that the right word? Cup. It's a big cup. But this is the perfect spot to spend the day while your tent overheats. I don't know if I got a proper shot of my back when I was showing you guys at the tent. I'll try not to expose too much of my bum. For Riley's sake, not for the viewer's sake. But is it still bad?
Hold on, let me check you out real quick.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
It's bad.
It's really bad.
Yeah, look at that tan line, guys.
Oh, that's not a tan line, that's just straight
burn line. That is true. What's the price you pay for not wearing sun cream? So, my fault. Play that game?
Yeah. No, lean back. Go, Mr. Krabs.
Will he make it? On this episode.
He's reaching.
Keep on going. You can't give up halfway. Persevere.
Oh, he's like.
Persevere. He's looking right at me. Go, son. Go.
Go, son.
Keep going. You're almost there. Oh, you can't get a grip. You can't get a grip.
Imagine he jumps on your face.
Oh, yeah. We found the frog, everybody. Oh, where's he going? Oh, wow, he's fast as. All right, Mr. Froggy. I am here to save you.
Go, go.
Go, go, keep swimming. Quick, keep swimming.
Go up, frog.
Up, up.
Are you literally gonna...
Oh!
Oh my God.
You went the wrong way. If you jumped that way, you would have been saved. I am a hero. See, now he's happy.
We've been practicing our water aerobics the past, 2 minutes?
Yeah, ready?
So this is
Nobody leaves our, baby in the corner.
This is our performance.
That was perfect!
Alright, we're gonna recap from the vlog and see what it looks like.
Alright, we also filmed on Riley's phone. Oh my, that was perfect!
That was perfect.
It's just, I got a little bit too low and you flipped over. Oh, that was good! We did that about 2 times beforehand and we sucked at it. Here's our other attempts. Alright guys, we're down at the beach area now. Where those red tents are is where like the beach glamping is. So those tents are for like private use, but you have all these ones for public use because obviously a lot of the tourists, they stay in El Nido town and they come up here for a day trip. So obviously they're not staying accommodation on the beach here. So they can rent out those for a couple hundred pesos. There's like jewelry sellers that come around. There's massages that you can get on the beach, which we're gonna get shortly, but obviously I can't get a back massage or I will probably cry in pain. So I think we might get a foot massage. There's plenty of like little cocktail bars, plenty of little shops, eat your ice cream and all that kind of stuff. So I'll show you around that area. We'll get a massage, foot massage, and we'll have a couple drinks by the beach. But yeah, it's just so beautiful. At this time, it's around like 1 p.m. and it is so hot. Just standing here at the moment, I can feel myself burning. Thankfully, got the Sri Lanka shirt on to keep us protected from the sun. But yeah, a couple people swimming out there, and why wouldn't you, to cool off in absolute paradise. It is just gorgeous out here, but it gets even better at sunset. Sunset's right over those two islands there, so if you time it perfectly, it goes straight down. The colors in the sky are just absolutely magnificent. So yeah, let's go get foot massages, and we'll bring you along for that. I'm excited. Haven't had a foot massage in ages. Tarana! Do you want to get a foot massage?
Yeah.
Can you do it for me? How much? 300 pesos?
Yeah.
3,000. 3,000. Nay, nay. Look how luxurious this place looks. Looks like a big villa that you can rent out. It's got like all the private access area. I think they're just painting it, so it looks like it's getting prepared for the high season here. But I think we can get a massage just from these ladies. They were telling us earlier on that we can get them. Hello. Can we get foot massages?
Yeah.
It's okay?
Yeah, now?
Yeah, how much are they?
I don't need 1 hour, sir, body.
30 minutes?
30 minutes, 250.
Okay, you just feet or?
Back massage?
Because I'm sunburned.
We have priest aloe vera.
Oh, you have real aloe vera?
Yeah, 350, add 100.
Sorry?
350.
Add 100 for the aloe vera.
Add 100.
Oh, 150. Okay. Yeah, but I think, do you reckon it will hurt?
30 minutes.
Okay.
Okay.
But you do soft because it's burning. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah.
And you want one?
Yeah. Can I get a foot massage?
Foot?
250.
250.
And then you 350. With aloe vera.
Yeah, with aloe vera. Perfect. Okay. This is it here.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then cut.
It's real. Oh, very good. All right.
Small.
Yeah, let's do that.
Hey.
Okay.
Wait.
No worries.
Yep.
That's perfect. That's so cool. It's like actual real aloe vera.
Mm. Perfect.
My granddad used to have a plant and chop it off, and he always put on my sunburn. It healed so much quicker.
Yeah,
than
this
any
is like this
stuff.
Is the natural stuff.
Yeah.
This is what I need. So in the sun, my sunburn looks a lot worse. But it's so bad, and this is like after 2 or 3 days. Does it look bad in the camera?
Yeah.
Oh, I hope she needs to go really soft or I'll be screaming in pain. It'll be funny though. But I think they're getting it all ready. I hope they have somewhere to wash off my feet because they're sandy.
Sorry, thank you. your the aloe vera.
Ah, very nice. Oh, oh, that is so soothing. Very good.
Does it look burnt, like, now? In the shade, it doesn't look that bad.
It's still pretty bad.
Yeah.
No.
Oh. Oh, very good. Relaxing. Freshening.
Blue.
How's your foot massage, Riley?
Good. Look at the view.
Yeah. So beautiful. I thought you get to face it. I don't. They should have flipped the cushion at the other end.
Yeah. It's really good.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful. Thank you.
Maybe I should just get the aloe vera applied and then get a foot massage.
Well, I think that's what she's doing.
Oh, okay.
I don't think she's going to massage you.
Yeah.
You like?
No, I'm fine. I'm not burnt.
Oh.
Use it all on him.
Yeah,
he needs it.
Is it an ice cube or is it?
It's, oh,
it's the actual aloe vera.
Ice.
Yeah, ice.
Same ice cube.
Smells like a cactus. Is aloe vera a cactus? Looks like it.
I don't know.
Leaves. Where is aloe vera?
It's leaves.
Leaves, yeah.
Leaves. It grows naturally in the Philippines?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is like a godsend that they do massages as well as aloe vera applications. Might have to make a few more trips down here. You're getting worked up.
I gave Riley the quick task of filming, but she needs to enjoy the relaxation.
Yeah, it's good pressure. It's actually not hurting as much as I thought. Pressing hard. It's actually not that sore though, surprisingly.
Wow.
Maybe the aloe vera is working. Yeah, it's not even hurting. But there's gonna be that one like slip where maybe her nail gets in. Like her nail slips and it's just gonna slice me. So peaceful. Well, that's a bit sore.
Okay.
Yeah, it's okay. So nice being outdoors, hearing the waves crashing, a little bit of background music, the fresh breeze. Unfortunately, I'm looking the wrong way though. At least I can hear the waves crashing against the sand. This actually isn't hurting as much as I initially thought it would. The thought of anyone putting pressure on my back in this sunburned state is not a good thought. It's turning out alright. So 350 pesos for me and 250 for Riley's. 100 extra because I got the aloe vera, which is good. but that's like around 7 US for mine and 5 US for yours. For 30 minutes. And I think an hour was only 100 more. That feels so good. The cold ice makes such a difference. But definitely worth it. Like $7 for 30 minutes. Worth every penny. And I know Riley can say the same because she's so good. I'm loving it. Finished?
Thank you very much.
Ooh. That's weird. Now that it stops, it's starting to hurt. But you can see all like little remainders of the aloe vera. Ooh, it's all over me. I literally smell like a leaf. That is what I am smelling like right now. Which is not a bad thing, because I know it's going to help my sunburn. Thank you very much. Perfect. There you go.
Or to who?
Perfect. Thank you. No change needed.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'll come back for more later, okay? Just down here lounging around at the beach. Just so beautiful. It looks like there's a couple storm clouds coming in, and that does seem to be a common occurrence here in the evening times. It's really usually good weather, maybe a little bit of rain in the morning, and then really good weather up until like 3 or 4. And then usually there's like a 30 minute, 1 hour thunderstorm. Luckily there wasn't one yesterday, but I think it was delayed a little bit till the middle of the night, and it was literally like the middle of the thunderstorm, the lightning. I said in the tent when I was giving you a review earlier, how it was like literally on us. Like you'd hear the lightning, or you'd see the lightning, and then instantly the thunder would come by. So it seems like there is something surging over there, but if you look this way, looks like absolute paradise. And there's even a motorcycle riding along the beach. Look at this guy. He's flying down. Tarana, Tarana. Let's go, let's go. Oh, he's slowing down. He's in the soft sand now. Watch out, watch out, watch out. Jeez, look at that guy. Oh, that's how you know you're in the Philippines, everybody. Riding motorbikes, riding scooters along the beach. It is around 4 p.m. at the moment, and sunset is truly on its way. You can see what I was talking about earlier is that it kind of sets right in between those two little islands over there. But around this time, this is when everything kind of comes to life. During the day it's super hot. This temperature right now is absolutely gorgeous. There's a small little breeze which makes it nice, but we got people playing volleyball. I've been seeing this like big mountain up here, and there's tons of boats up here, so we're gonna go check that out, see what is going on up there. And it seems to be a little bit more of like the secluded side of the beach, but can you imagine just this here? Dirt bikes, scooters. I'm sure the local people and those with motorbikes have an absolute ball flying up this like hard bit of sand here. It would be so much fun. And a couple of times, I've only caught it on video once, but a few times today, people have just been flying. You can see the tire marks from all the people that have been flying down the beach, going down that way. But it's just a massive beach here, guys. Gotta be like, what, 8 or 9 kilometers long. It loops all the way around, and it's just absolute paradise out here. And I think you can see my face is severely burnt. I've been focusing way too much today on keeping my back sun protected, and I totally forgot that my face is always in the sun. And I've even developed a little bit of a hat tan line that you guys can enjoy. So I think we'll be keeping the hat backwards for a while to cover up that. Look at all these little fishermen boats here. I saw them when I was all the way down there, but there's literally hundreds and hundreds here. Down, boy. And it seems that they're like all crab traps or some kind of trap to catch all the crabs or the other creepy crawlies at the bottom of the ocean. So these are probably used to take those out, so the rest of the island has fresh seafood available. Down, boy. Stay down. But yeah, there's just hundreds of them. Look at them. They're literally like really traditional Filipino boats. That is so cool. And there's like a little community there, people that are living. What a gorgeous place to live, right on paradise here. We've got a couple chickens
roaming around in the greenery. Oh, there's three there. They're like, they're just like, just the perfect height to be hidden, like that little guy. Oh, there's another one up there. But I was walking up here and I thought I saw, yeah, I did, another beach. So this just might be like a big island that's kind of separating the two beaches. This looks absolutely amazing. Got all the kids playing in nature, and is that a basketball hoop? Well, it's a backboard. Oh, this is gorgeous. Look at the palm trees right by the sunset. This beach doesn't seem as nice as that one. That one's like super white, yellow sand. This one's a little bit kind of darker. It's got debris, like seaweed on the shores. But wow, this is just so fascinating. Walking through all these kind of like little homes on the side. It's just so beautiful once you go up to the other end of the beach. Barely anyone around. You got this whole beautiful area all to yourselves. And I haven't been wearing shoes, guys, but I just found a flip-flop. So maybe we'll be able to find a second one to pair it. But we'll wear this for the rest of the day. Try and, oh, I got bitten by a sandfly. Look at this thing. They're called knick-knicks, I think. And they're like little sandflies that just bite you, and they're so annoying. I've been getting absolutely attacked here the past couple days that we've been here. And it's not enjoyable. Look, I have all these marks. I've got scratches like down my legs. Look, those are all knick-knicks. And they're so itchy. Like, you're not meant to itch bites, but these are just irresistible. I can't not itch them, they're so itchy. So that's one thing you gotta be careful of when you're here in El Nido. Cause there's, I think, knick-knicks or nip-nips. They're everywhere. And they hurt. Look how beautiful this is, guys. Made it all the way to the end here. It literally just loops around like kilometers and kilometers, but the sun is just over that way. I'm gonna try and scale all these rocks. And honestly, I think as an Australian, the best bet to do that is barefoot. Because this is starting to cut me up. See all the red marks, so we'll leave that there. Pick it up on the return journey, and we'll scale this on our feet, barefoot. Oh, that is sharp. Oh, maybe this wasn't such a good idea. Oh my God, these are so sharp. There's no way I'm making it. All right, plan two. Look for a second pair of thongs. I feel like this is the place that they would wash up on. There aren't any though. All right, plan three. Let's go for a swim. As we scale back. Oh, oh, oh. Ooh. Let's do it. I don't even know if that was a good transition. I thought I'd spice up my video. You know how I like to keep it raw? I don't usually have those transitions like that, but we'll see if it worked out well. But so beautiful. The water temperature here is literally perfect. Not too hot, not too cold, just exactly what you need to freshen up. I just can't believe, like, I'm actually staying here. This is my life. It's crazy. It's like I'm living in a movie. Just looking around, it's just an oasis. It just looks like it's out of this world. It's so damn beautiful. Oh, and the sun right there. I could just watch sunset from here. Let's do it. I'll sit down. Perfect sunset view. That sun behind me. Let's face this way so we're glowing. Haha, this is paradise. Wow. It's so beautiful. It's golden hour. I can't believe it. All right, guys, we made it to the Sun Mae. Oh, every single time I have to like talk in between the music because it plays super loudly. But Sun Mae, this is the restaurant. It's a glamping's over there. This is their sister hotel behind, which is like actual accommodation and actual rooms, but they have this restaurant here. We have complimentary breakfast here, and they also have a really good menu. And behind me, there is a pizza oven. And we had pizza last night, and it was, what'd you say? Like, best pizza in it.
In the Philippines. For sure. We only have tried two different pizzas.
the other one was pretty good as well.
The other one was pretty good. Wasn't a fan of the bacon.
That is true. But this one here, they cook it up in there and it is on point. It is masarap, as you say here in the Philippines. That means delicious. Masarap.
Masarap.
Yeah, it is masarap. But I was going to show you guys today kind of the area because there's like an I Love Nakpan. See, this is what I'm dealing with. Hopefully it doesn't get copyrighted. They have like an I Love Nakpan big logo, but they just play music so loudly all during the day. It's not that bad at the moment, but during the day it's like absolutely blasting. Hello.
Hi. So you have already ordered?
Oh yeah, we've already ordered. Here's the food.
Beautiful, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Sorry, I just get the utensil. I forget.
Thank you. Chips and dessert first.
Mocha crumble.
Well, one is it? Mocha crumble.
Yeah. It's not warm, so we can wait for it.
Really? Oh, the chips are super hot. Anyways, we'll wait until the pizza comes, and I'll show you that. There's one pizza being done. So they got their pizza. I'm going to go up and show you guys the pizza making process. The speaker's right there. Oh, that's our one. I want to show. Kamusta ka, kuya? You're making the pizzas? Oh, very good. All right, we'll taste it. Oh, yeah. Hawaiian. This is the best pizza in the Philippines, everybody. And I know. Oh, my God, it's so hot. It's so hot. Oh my God. It's foppy as well. Ah, look at that. It just, all right. 1 minute and we'll be back with you. Here we go. Let's try it out. It's a bit floppy at the end there. Mmm. That is good. Freshly made in the wood oven behind us. It's really good. Honestly, like, on pizza standards, in the Philippines here, 10 out of 10. Maybe the global scale, with Italy and all that involved, 8.5.
Thank you, sir. Bravo, Once again, marami salamat kay Madam Patricia.
8.5.
Patricia, thanks.
Oh, what is happening?
Drink.
Sorry, 8.5.
8.5. As I was saying this morning, guys, they have actually complimentary bonfires, and we're walking in from dinner. Sounds like there's a dog attack, and this kuya was like, "Do you want to watch? Want to start the bonfire?" So we added a little bit of. It is gasoline or diesel? Gasoline.
Diesel.
Diesel. Well, that means it burns slower. This is like my number one nightmare.
I know.
With like flammable liquids. But there we are. It's all going. Ready to enjoy. Luckily the smoke's going that way. We'll sit over here. Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you. These are the longest sticks I've ever seen in my life. Thank you so much. All right, I'm rolling them out towards the fire.
Here, I'll hold this one. Wait, which colors? Yeah. Oh my God, this is like the perfect length. Right, how do you like your marshmallows, Riley?
I like them crispy on the outside, gooey in the middle.
Yeah, you're hitting me.
You reckon the goo? Okay. Little, stay in your lane. Ah, get away! I think I'm gooped to you. That's like, that's trauma. I don't trust you. Oh.
Oh no, oh no, oh no. Oh my God, this is horrible. This is horrible. I'm on fire. I can't get it in fast enough. No. Is it off?
Oh, mine's perfect.
Except it's not on one side. That actually does look good though. Did you get another one?
Yeah. This is my back door.
You got an ember on it.
Sabotage.
There's a stick on it.
Hurry up and eat it.
I'm getting perfect. Alright, I'm gonna try. Look at, oh my God.
There's a stick on, melted onto it. There's ash everywhere.
Oh my god. By the way, I have a second perfect marshmallow.
Look at the ash you put on it on this side.
Oh, yum. Do you want my secondly perfectly cooked marshmallow?
Please. That's so good.
Are you gonna have one?
Maybe I should not vlog and actually focus on my cooking skills. I tipped him 200 pesos because he was holding the umbrella for us. But part of that agreement was that he gave us two more marshmallows. Or gave me two more marshmallows. So this is our tent at night time. You can barely see it. But with the flick of this switch, whoa, look at that. Absolute paradise. Good morning, guys. Look at the day we have upon us. Another cracker of a day, but it's damn hot still, so we can make use of the pool and all the beaches and stuff. But we're gonna head to breakfast shortly, and then we gotta check out around 12 p.m., head back to El Nido. So we'll probably get breakfast, clean up, and then maybe head down to where those markets were yesterday, maybe get another foot massage and a couple cocktails at lunchtime. So we'll see what happens. Taranau, let's do it. So we're back at the Sun Mi restaurant. This is what I wanted to show you guys yesterday, but the music was super loud. But we got the I Love Nakpen big sign here. They have these all over Lebanon as well, in like Juni, Bashari, and then that's like the reception area. So as I was saying, that hotel there is like owned by the same people. So you check in there. At the moment they don't have an ATM, and thankfully they have card, but I withdrew a lot of cash thinking that we'd have to pay all with cash. But yeah, look how beautiful this day is, guys. We shall eat breakfast here, which is complimentary. We put in our order last night, and we'll try it out. Keen to get some coffee. Oh, they're dropping off the coconuts. Come with the car, brother. What are you doing? Coconut delivery.
Yeah,
supplies. The Carabar. We're back down at the main market area, kind of the public area. I just tried to go to that cocktail bar where they were dropping off the coconuts, but he said come back in like 30 minutes. So while we wait, we're gonna get a foot massage for about 30 minutes, and then we'll go get cocktails. It's around 10 a.m. at the moment, so this isn't too busy here just yet. I think like around midday is when it starts to kind of get busy, but everyone's kind of setting up shop, getting ready for the day. Tons of people swimming, and these massage ladies are packing up as well. Well, it's getting set up, I should say. All right, we just got massages done. I didn't film a single second of it because it was so relaxing. Perfect view to get a beach massage. But now it should be time to get cocktails, I think. It's never too early to get a cocktail. So let's pay them and then we'll go get cocktails. Welcome to Carabar. Cocktails, fresh fruit, Long Island iced teas. Kuya!
Yes.
Kamusta ka? Cocktails are ready now? We can do cocktail?
Yeah, I do it now.
You do it? Which one is the best one?
What is? Pina colada.
Alright, we'll have one pina colada, please.
Yeah.
And you make here? That is the one from the coconut, right?
Yeah.
From this old coconut? So apparently the pina colada, somehow it's made from these coconuts. I think it gets chopped up inside and then mushed up, but we'll see the whole process. We got the machete. Kuya, kamusta ka? That one, that's the unlucky one for today. All right, let's see what happens. All right. So it's made inside, like this is the cup?
Yeah, nope. We're gonna get the... We grind this.
Oh, you grind it?
Yeah, and then we squeeze it to get the milk.
To get out the coconut milk?
Yeah.
Is it the water or the white flesh?
There's the water as well, but it's not really sweet.
Uh-huh, because it's old.
Yeah.
Wow. And then pina colada, what alcohol is in there?
It's white rum and
white
rum and lime juice.
Okay.
And pineapple.
Very good. Alright. So the coconut is out of the husk. It's crazy how just like old coconuts end up with that kind of big center bit, whereas the green ones you can just chop straight through and get to all the coconut juice. But I imagine
this is our manual machine.
Whoa, what is this? That is how
this is how we grind,
how you get the wow,
yeah, the meat.
That is awesome.
Manual machine.
Oh, so that's not good water, right? You can you drink or not?
You can drink as well.
Yeah, it's safe.
Yeah, it's safe, yeah? But it's not really
not
sweet.
Not
bitter.
Because it's old.
Yeah, you want to try?
All right. It's not very sweet, but let's try it. Oh, it's just like water.
Yeah.
It's just normal water. Not very. It's just. I don't know. Wow, so this, the manual machine, that's how it gets all the white flesh. See, oh, when the coconuts are brown like that, the meat bit is just so much better than when I have like the green ones on the street. So if you want like more coconut meat, you just wait for it to get really old. But if you want the water, you got to get it while it's young. But, wow, like that is so thick. So the Karo bar, we're getting the pina colada, but there's so many other ones. Maybe they all have their own unique way of being made and kind of fresh. This is such a long process, but $2.50 for all of them basically. That's around $5. But let's see what happens here.
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. So you try to get everything out?
Yeah. Need to finish this meat.
Yeah.
Yeah. You wanna try this one? How to do it?
Okay, yeah.
Just be careful, because...
It's sharp?
This one, yeah, it's...
I'll watch for a little bit, and I'll learn from the expert.
Yeah. This one.
Okay, yeah, yeah, do that one.
You need to... First, you need the side, this one.
Yeah.
Before the...
Before the middle.
Side, yeah. Because it hurts if you start inside.
So pina colada is the best selling one, number
yeah,
one?
Because we make our own like style.
Yeah.
Like actually in the other bar the milk it's like in the pack.
Oh yes, but this one's fresh.
This one is fresh.
Can I try?
Yeah, can I try? That's good.
Oh, that's so good. That's so yummy.
That is so good.
It's
never
so
had
fresh.
Freshly.
Yeah, this is literally as fresh as it gets. Straight from the husk.
Yeah.
It takes so long, right?
Yeah.
So sometimes you're like very busy, you have lots of customers wanting
the
cocktails.
Watching how to do it.
Yeah. Wow. So this is just for one cocktail or you can do for lots?
No, one coconut is good for two cocktails.
Ah, for two, okay.
For pina colada, yeah.
Yeah. almost done.
Yeah, it's almost.
Now it's just the coconut semicircle. So look how much stuff came out there. The bowl's like half full. And we still got this one.
Wow.
Done.
It's done. You wanna try this one?
Yeah, you do this one as well? I'll try quickly.
Try quick. I teach you how.
So you hold like this and you wanna get the top there, right?
No, this one. This is the first.
Yeah.
Put in before the inside. Yes, be careful in your hands, huh?
Where should I hold my hands?
Yeah, it's like that. In bush leg.
Oh, like this?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah, like that.
How many years have you done this for?
When I was young.
Like
11 years old, I do
that. Wow, and how old are you now?
It's 21.
So you have 10 years?
Yeah.
So you're so fast. I'm getting the hang of it. I'm super slow. Philippines best bartender, Luke Demand. Well, look at my shreds compared to... Mine are like so much more gloopy compared to yours. Alright, I get back to the expert. Otherwise, we'll be here all day. Look at the difference, so much faster. But it's so cool. Look at that. And that's just literally the coconut husk, or the coconut outer layer. That's so cool. So after about 10 minutes, everything is done. Well, we have the coconut shreds, the little slices. So now you mix into milk, or?
Yeah, I put this little bit of water of coconut. And then I'm gonna squeeze.
Ah, very good. This is such an awesome process. Like the amount of, you know, extensive work that is done, the precision, all the processes, it's crazy. We've been here for about 10 to 15 minutes, getting this all done. And it's gonna taste damn good at the end. Especially when you have a view like this of the beach, sipping on your pina coladas, it'll be good. Alright, so the gloves are on. So how many shots worth?
Just one.
Just one?
Yeah.
Wow. That's all it takes.
Just the...
Oh! Milk. Wow. You can see it congregating on the side there. It's getting like mushed up. Kind of like whipped like butter. Being mixed around. Wow. Oh my god. So that's all been squeezed out, that's all the dry stuff, leaving the milk behind. Can I eat this?
Yeah, but it's not tasty.
No, it's because it's no milk.
Yeah.
Mmm. I like it.
Still good.
Yeah. Oh. Yum. Oh, more. It's like the coconut that they put on Lamingtons in Australia. Yeah, dried out. But wow. All that milk. Came from that. Next up, it goes through the sieve to make sure it's just liquid and no coconut shreds. And there we have it. Half a cup of fresh coconut milk.
It's the milk.
Wow. It's such a long process for just half a cup.
Yeah, before I mix, I just
I'll try.
Try this
okay.
One.
Wow.
You want a drink?
Yes, please.
That is delicious. That is so good.
Thank you.
It's so creamy.
That is so nice.
It's just like the coconut. Yeah, the texture is really nice as well. It's just like the coconut milk, or like coconut water and the flesh mixed together. But such a, like I've said many times when I've been drinking the coconut water and had like the flesh afterwards, the taste is like very faint. It's only like a small bit of coconut that you taste, but this is like pungent as, and it tastes delicious. So the next step, pineapple. All right, the pineapple is in the blender. We got the coconut milk there. All right, coconut milk is in. All of it. Very good. And what alcohol? White rum.
White rum. This one.
One shot. And then coconut rum. Yeah. What percentage alcohol is that? 27.
Yeah.
27.5%. So just like a normal spirit. So two shots mixed with everything. And that is lime juice.
Yes, half.
Half a shot. Oh, it's green. Wow. Oh. Bit of ice in there.
We're gonna do something to make it beauty.
Oh, we got the umbrellas.
Yeah.
With the pineapples. Oh. Perfect. How long have we been here? 30 minutes, right?
25.
The process is so long, which is good. Is it stressful when it's busy and you have lots of customers because they're...
No, it's not.
Or you have multiple people working?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good. Ooh, what is that?
It's a jelly, huh?
Jelly.
Cherry.
Cherries.
Yeah, cherries.
Oh, going above and beyond.
Cherries, cherries.
Oh, with the pineapple as well. Perfect.
Yeah. Right.
Almost finished.
Almost. It's take a long time.
Does it every time it takes this long?
No.
No? Because sometimes you have prepared the...
Prepared already.
Yeah. Alright, everything's in there, let's mix it up. Alright.
Right.
Oh, finally. It comes in a... Yeah, finally. It comes in a bamboo cup. That's the pina colada, everybody.
Nakpan
Pina Colada, the best pina colada at Nakpan Beach, or maybe even here in the Philippines. We'll see. We've got the final touch here, and that is how you make a pina colada from scratch, everybody. This is what we rated for. We got a little handle. Oh, I won't grab it by the handle. Exactly what I thought would happen happened. Let's try it out, everybody. What I'll do actually, I'll face the beach so I feel like I'm really on a holiday. Wow, that is muscle up. That is so fresh, so cooling on a hot day. That is delicious. Try that out, Riley. Prepare your mind to be blown.
Oh my god.
That is just...
where else would you get something this fresh?
Yeah.
Like that takes is amazing. Like
30 minutes to do. In Sydney, they're just like, oh, all right, 30 seconds,
the
done.
Syrups, the everything, like.
They're just like trying to get as much volume out as possible. But here,
they're trying
wow.
to really blow your world.
That is good. We'll have to come back and get another one later on. This is delicious.
I actually don't usually like pina coladas.
Really?
But I would order one of these every single
yeah,
day of the week.
Like,
it's so different to anything I've tried before.
I think the fresh coconut milk makes a massive difference. It makes it just so much more creamy.
Pineapple
the texture.
Tongues,
yeah.
Like, it's just next level.
It's perfect. Well, thank you for cleaning up my mess. Oh, this is so good.
Enjoy, enjoy.
How perfect. Perfect day, blue water. Incredible.
Already.
That was so good. I did it so fast. That was absolutely delicious. That is, where do you get the recipe from?
It's my own recipe.
You made it, yeah? You've perfected it.
Running the bar.
Oh, you're the owner? Yeah. Oh, nice.
I've been running this 3 years before.
3 years?
Yeah.
Wow, yeah.
And then the resume stuff were shut down for 2 years.
But now it's picking up, now it's good?
We just started all of the businesses here, we just started reopening last March.
Ah, very good.
So far so good. It's not that much as before, but it's a good thing.
Yeah, it'll pick up,
back,
right? Yeah. No, that was delicious. Thank you so much. Here, you guys can keep the change. That was delicious.
Only one drink?
Yeah, that's fine.
Wow.
It's so good. We'll be coming back for more later, okay?
Wow, yeah.
Thank you so much, guys.
Okay.
Have a good day. All right, guys, we're doing a rapid speed pack because that drink took way longer than we expected. We gotta check out and catch a transfer back to El Nido today. That cocktail was damn good. And I'm sweating like crazy in this tent. It's like midday at the moment. And it gets so hot during the day. But hopefully, if we're fast enough here, we can get our bags to reception, quickly go back for another cocktail, we'll get a different one, and then make it in time for our taxi back to El Nido. So, Tarana, let's get on with this.
See you again.
Yeah, I'm back. Yeah. It's too hot. We need some refreshing drinks.
Uh-huh.
Which one is next bestseller? So pina colada is good.
Yeah.
Is the margarita good? It's the one with the from the coconut, right?
Uh huh. Yeah.
And
coconut
what,
rum.
What flavors are there? There's mango.
Yeah. Cucumber.
Cucumber.
And I don't recommend you with the pineapple.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we have one mango?
Margarita.
Frozen margarita, please.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Excuse me, what's your name?
Luke. Luke, L-U-K-E.
From Australia?
Yeah.
We have also another guy yesterday, same guy, also from Australia.
Oh, really?
Luke.
Really? Was it me?
No. you're more handsome than him.
Oh, thank you. Porgy?
He recognize you.
Oh, he recognized me.
I watch your videos.
Ah, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching.
Blogger?
Yeah, like YouTube and Facebook.
YouTube.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be in the film.
Yeah, are you making it?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your name?
Mimi.
Mimi.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
The real master.
The master, the expert. So you're the one that trains all the staff.
Yeah. George is my guy.
Yeah.
He's been also in my bar like since where we started.
Yeah. Wow. It's sounds a good
like,
good
yeah.
coconut. Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah, when there's water, it means it's a good one.
And what's your name?
All right. So the last one we had, they used the coconut, kind of like jelly stuff, to make it into milk. I think this one, for this one, do you use the water or the coconut? Or what
just the coconut.
as a glass.
As a glass.
The water we just
you throw away.
Away, yeah. If you want, you can.
The water is safe to drink.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The different in the young one, because the young one it can be really sweet.
Yeah, this when is just.
Yeah, when it's old, it's bland.
Yeah. No just size. Normal water. Yeah. Yeah. So they use the husk or the actual coconut part as the drink. How cool. How many coconuts do you use per day?
For 1 week, I have like 50 coconuts.
50, so this is for 1 week?
Uh-huh.
And this will last?
It still depends. If it's like a lot of people,
yeah.
This one can only last for 3 days.
And you buy them from Nakpan?
Yeah. Sometimes if I cannot buy, I have to climb.
Yeah, you have to climb again.
But normally here, we try to know all coconut in the tree.
Yeah, because it falls on people, yeah. Right? Uh-huh. Do many people die from coconut?
In my own experience, it's only one.
Only one person?
Yeah, one of my cousins died.
Wow, that's sad to hear.
I was playing with her.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it's quite common, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
So far, that's the only one that I know.
Yeah.
But I have, for sure, you know, I know all over the country, there's,
yeah, there's lots
of coconuts.
Yeah.
Hot today.
Really hot.
It is very hot.
No wind.
Yeah. I think that's the difference between yesterday and today, is that there's just no breeze whatsoever. Here we go. This is for the bottom, like to
make to it
sit.
Stand.
Yeah. So you're from this island, from Nakpan, or?
Yeah, I was born and raised here. All of my siblings. This is our beach every day.
Yeah, paradise.
Sometimes you get tired.
Yeah.
Looking good.
Well, when you get tired, then you just drink margarita.
Coconut man.
Yeah, he's got a nose.
Yeah, and eyes. Where are you about in Australia?
Sydney.
Sir.
Hello.
Excuse me.
Oh, is the transfer here?
Yes, sir. Your man is waiting.
Oh,
for you.
No. Oh, God. I thought it was 12 o'clock, right?
They told us 12. Yes, I arrived earlier.
Okay. We have 5 minutes. Is it okay? 5 minutes, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Take your time.
Thank you very much.
Sir, I don't know.
All right, Mimi. We may have to move extra fast, if possible. Because we have a taxi to catch.
I have to use being a master.
Yeah. This is what you've trained your life for.
Yeah.
To be quick.
Mm-hmm.
I go first, sir.
Yeah, I come. 2 minutes, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much.
2 minutes.
What time is it now? Is it 12?
No,
no,
it's
11:30.
It comes early.
Yeah.
Oh, what is this little kid doing?
Hello.
Playing with a hose.
My daughters.
Oh, your daughter?
Yeah. Before I was a lifeguard here.
Oh, you're a lifeguard?
Yeah. Before we are 15 lifeguards around here. But at the moment, there are only 4.
Yeah.
So watching this, like, giving me more idea how to rescue people.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Run away. Alright, so we're almost getting to the end, I think. And meanwhile, I think, oh yeah, the mango cherry is all being prepared. So I think we'll be able to get this done speedily. Hello. Hi. What's your name?
Mia.
Mia. Hi, Mia. Hi, Mia. Oh
that.
Yeah, so I can see the water coming out.
Ah, what you look?
Ah, all right. So the top comes off. Oh, is there a seed? What is that? Oh, it's
that means this coconut is growing.
Ah,
it's becoming another.
So it'll be a coconut in a coconut.
Yeah.
All right, let's try this.
Coconut.
Good.
Yeah, it's like as you said, very bland.
Yeah.
Not
no,
very
no taste, yeah.
Not much coconut taste, uh-huh. Just water.
A lot of Australian people will come here.
Yeah, well, Australian people, they love alcohol. And they love bars at the beach.
Yeah.
So this is paradise for us. It doesn't get much better than this.
Wow.
So what alcohol is in? Is tequila?
Tequila.
Of course.
Yeah.
One big shot. Oh, we get another one. It's two shots in?
Yeah.
Very good. At night time, do you pack everything up or it stays out?
We just put it inside here.
Oh, and lock it.
George and I have another guy.
Uh-huh.
He was playing a volleyball yesterday, so they're not here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're sleeping here.
Yeah, yeah.
In the hammock.
Oh. He sleeps in the hammock at night?
Yeah.
What about the sandflies? They don't attack him?
They just have to drink gin before they sleep.
Then they don't wake up. And what one is that?
This one is a triple sec.
Uh-huh.
Triple sec.
Oh, triple sec.
Yeah.
Very good.
Are you good with the lime juice?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it part of the recipe?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so we got the mangoes, we got all the alcohol.
My sneaking.
Oh yeah, make it strong.
Yeah.
That's four shots. Uh-huh. And I'm gonna drink it in about 2 minutes.
Wow.
Because we gotta get to this bus, this taxi might be an interesting ride home. Bit of ice. Kamusta ka, kuya? Crazy. The coconut straight from its raw form over there and then being made just like this. Perfect. Bamboo straw to finish it all off.
Yeah. Everything
and
here.
Bit of salt.
We made our own glass here.
That is so cool.
Trying to be different from any others.
Yeah. All right.
There you go. Look.
Thank you. Let's try it out. Overlooking the beach. Wow. That is so strong.
Yeah.
It's so strong and good.
Something you need in this kind of weather.
Yeah.
Strong.
All right. Thank you so much. We have a bus to catch.
Yeah.
And there's our guy. There, you can keep the change.
Wow,
nice to meet you. When I come back, I'll order more. Maybe in a couple months.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet
you.
Thank
see you,
you
later.
So much.
Bye-bye. What do you think of it?
So strong.
It's so strong.
It's so strong.
Thank you. Well guys, we're back at El Nido Beach, back in paradise. Although, I mean, we were in paradise the past couple days up at glamping, but it is good to be back with these beautiful mountains and the beautiful waves and all that kind of stuff. But glamping, an amazing experience. Definitely highly recommend it. As someone that has like loved camping all their life, and as I said at the very beginning of this video, I used to camp with my parents and my family and friends every year in Australia. So it's good to be able to glamp and not have to pack up everything, although I guess that is part of actual camping, is the pack up, the setting up everything. But it was good just to have the tent there, nice mattresses, really good facilities, and of course it was on, you know, some beautiful water just like this. Just with like every other hotel and all the like excursions and tours and all that kind of stuff, I pay like the full amount. I book it through like booking.com or something. I never do like collaborations or like partnerships or sponsorships or anything like that, because I want to be able to give you like an authentic experience. And I feel that if I was paid to stay there or if I got free accommodation, I'd have to kind of be dishonest and say you know, good things about the hotel when it's not actually good. But it was a good stay and I paid full price for it. Like it was $130 US a night, I think. But Tarana, thank you so much for watching the video, everybody. As always, chase your dreams, and we'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.